Get ready to match the stars from Lou Grant, Daryl Anderson, Red Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from Angie Donna Pascal, from Carter Country, Richard Paul, and Patty Deutsch, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 79. And now, here's the star of Match Game 79,
now for my first number on the piccolo, I will play. Oh! Yeah, we got a marching band here from Denver. Okay, calm down.
Cut!
Is there a piccolo player in the group? Okay, just wanted to know if I was holding it right. Now, for my next number, I'm going to trim Pinocchio's nose.
And my little dog, too.
You really can. Just in the nick of time. Thank you, Pete. That was quick work. I mean, he ran back to his tool chest and pulled. I just got a glimpse of him with his nose on, and I said, I've got to do something about that. Oh, listen. Would you like to play us a song on my musical saw?
There. Anything other than the nose. No surgery.
All right.
Could you
now we'll come
this?
Over here. Yes, about your hat.
You're not going to cut my hat, are you, with that thing?
No.
Are somebody
you the sheriff? Is that your sheriff's hat?
No,
a mayor's hat?
I was out punching cows all day. Bruised my knuckles.
Oh. Now let's say hello to a new player here and an old player. Well, she's not too old there. Linda Rutherford is our old player, and Barbara Fain. Applause, applause, applause.
Come on, everybody. Got crazy now that you have that song.
What do you say, Barbara?
After that.
Listen, we welcome you. It's nice to have you here, my dear.
Thank you.
You have Cher here, don't you?
I do, all the way.
Oh, really? How far do you go?
This is a daytime show, is it not?
Yeah. Would you like a little trim? Tell us where you're from.
Well, originally I'm from New York.
Aren't we all,
more.
My dear?
Yeah, aren't we? A little bit about myself is that...
Well, you know, have you got any hobbies? You're married, you're single,
sure
you fool around? What are yours? What are you?
All of the above.
Oh, all of the above.
Well, literally, I rent out for parties.
Really?
Yes. Well, actually...
She cooks, too, is what she means.
Well, actually, I work for a catering service in Los Angeles. Yes.
Really?
Yes. It's very, very nice company.
Yes.
My interests are that I study acting and astrology and vibrational meditation.
Really?
Yes.
I hesitate to ask. As a matter of fact, I won't.
Yes.
No. Okay. Now, Barbara, we're going to ask you to make a selection here. About A or B in round one.
I believe I'll take B for Barbara, please.
B for Barbara. All right. This says, Old Man Periwinkle is so old...
How old is he?
It's nice when you have a marching band in here. Because they do things in unison, and they take direction.
You should have said...
Oh, they'd walk to their seats in formation, too. Okay, we shall call upon you later. Old Man Periwinkle is so old, he's the only man in the world whose Social Security card is printed on...
Blank?
On blank.
On
what
blank.
Is it again?
Okay, Barbara Fain. Charles is just finishing up, right, Charles?
Yup.
Old Man Periwinkle is so old, the only man in the world whose Social Security card... is printed on...
Stone.
Stone is good! Good. these people here have half a brain, they will have said stone.
Half a brain and a sore nose. His social security number. Printed on parchment.
Parchment. Well, that's okay. Stone is a little older than parchment.
And so are you.
I said everything but parchment and bark.
Parchment and bark. Okay. Old Man Perwick says the only man in the world whose social security card is printed on stone.
Stone or rock.
Stone or rock is another one for Barbara Bean. Yes, sir?
Did you put that down first?
Oh. All right.
Before I...
Okay.
Parchment, I'm sorry.
Hit him again, huh?
Okay. Patty.
A Dead Sea Scroll.
A Dead Sea Scroll. That would be old. Matter of fact, that might be older than the stone, come to think of it. So, Barbara, you picked up two with that round. Yours will be long in a moment. Right now, we have this for you. Here we go. Okay, the other round, one question for Linda Rutherford. Harry said my wife gets all her... Harry said my wife gets all her recipes out of a magazine. Unfortunately for me... the magazine is blank.
Oh, boy.
Harry said my wife gets all her recipes out of a magazine. Unfortunately for me, the magazine is...
only thing I can think of is a Playgirl.
Playgirl? She said Playgirl, Daryl.
I said Popular Mechanic.
Popular Mechanic. That would be quite indigestible, wouldn't it?
Well, honey, you know I'm very butch and I'm very athletic-minded and I'm very a big sports fan and figure and all of that. So I said Sports Illustrated.
Sports Illustrated?
What did you say, hon?
She needs help.
Popular Mechanic.
Popular Mechanic.
Right on.
No one's come to my answer yet. Maybe Donna has it. Let's see what she has.
Popular Mechanics.
No, that's not my answer. I just clarified a little spelling there. Yes?
Well, I was close. Hustler.
Hustler.
A magazine, of course, that I've never read, never seen in my entire life.
And a magazine also completely devoid of recipes.
And anything else.
Right. What do you got to say for this, Patty?
Road and Track.
Road and Track. Well, they're all very good, but I think mine was the best.
What
now
was
that I think about Dog World.
Oh, I like that.
Betty White's like gonna get you.
Okay, here we go to round two. 2-0. And Barbara, let's see what you want, A or B.
I'll stick with B, please.
Okay, four people play. Brett and Donna Layout. Dumb Dora the nurse is so dumb.
How dumb is she?
They're brilliant.
You really are wonderful. You must come back every other weekend. Dumb, this nurse, when she heard that the patient had chicken pox, she tried to inoculate him with blank.
Oh, I wish I had blank. Yes, I know.
Help him out so we don't wait a week there. As soon as Daryl's finished.
He's finished.
Okay, Chuck, you ready?
Yo, Gene, yo.
That's why they call him a yo-yo. Dumb Dora the nurse is so dumb. When she heard that the patient had chicken pox, she tried to inoculate him with...
the old family cure, chicken soup.
Chicken soup. Very good. Seems to me that's the definitive answer. I can't think of a better one.
The definitive answer?
I would think so.
Give him some chicken soup.
Chicken soup already. Well-known family remedy.
Yes. After 6 years, I found a way to get out. Maybe chicken fat. I mean, I know some fatty soups and some soupy fats.
Yes, of course.
And I know some fatties.
Yeah. All right, Barbara, you got three. Let's not do any fat jokes, Brett.
Oh, sorry.
Let he among you who is without sin cast the first stone.
That's us, hon.
Yes. Okay, Richard.
Oh, my turn. You know, when you said inoculate, I wasn't thinking of what goes in. I was just thinking of the needle itself. So I said in a pastoral, bucolic answer, a pitchfork.
Oh, dear. Oh. Okay, Patty. Ooh.
Farmerette number
two. Chicken soup, hold the matzo ball.
Right.
Chicken soup, hold the matzo ball. So four for her.
And you got one more shot at it right after this. Ready? Okay. Now let me hear the way it is. This is the last question for you. You need four to tie, five to win. At the symphony orchestra,
yes.
The world's hungriest termite said, no matter how much I eat, I always have room for a blank. One more there. Finish, Brett.
Just barely.
At the symphony orchestra, the world's hungriest termite said, no matter how much I eat, I always have room for a...
bass.
A bass. Bass, she said.
I thought about giving that answer, but I thought it would be something smaller. I said a violin.
A violin?
I figured after that bass, yeah, I know. I
you need four to tie here. Let's see what Brett has.
After 43 string instruments, I ended up with violin.
Violin. I got to match everybody else here. And let's see what Charles has.
I say it was very hungry. Good old Steinway.
Good old Steinway. So that means Barbara Faisley said, what do you have? Piano or two. Now, piano to go, naturally. Okay. Now, Linda Rutherford's leaving here with $7,650.
Thanks.
Get to the star wheel a little bit later. Right now, we'll start at the top and say, we polled a studio audience not too long ago, a very smart bunch like these, and we said, write down your best answer to this, blank transplant. Now, if you give us the answer they wrote down most often, you get $500, and for matching their second most popular answer, $250, and then for matching the third most popular, $100, three of the six loons will help.
Charles, please.
You've been called on.
Hey, listen, her hair is down to her.
I mean,
take a look.
Right to her blanks.
Oh. I thought it goes a little bit past her blanks.
hair transplant.
Hair transplant. Whatever made you say that?
Because I had a heart already.
Heart.
Okay.
Brett,
what about your friendly kidney? Yeah.
Kidney transplant, heart those transplant, and hair transplant. Isn't this a jolly show? Okay, you may choose one of those or give us one of your own.
I'll go with hair.
Hair transplant. Wait a minute. What would you have said? You've got to have heart. Okay, they say that heart is the answer, but she said, Barbara says hair is the answer. We'll find out right now who is right. May we see the $100 number? Kidney transplant was Brett's answer. Moving up the ladder there, maybe see the $250 number. Here it is. You got it, Barbara. $250 for you. Well, we'll find out if the audience is right now. They said heart transplant. Slide the big one. And they were right. Patty's answer. Now, the least you'll play for is 10 times that amount, or $2,500, but let's go over here and let you spin the wheel and see if you double your money and play for $5,000 instead of $2,500. Good luck to you. It must make one revolution, and we're rooting for a double. Here we go. All right. right. You did not double your money, but you're playing with Richard Paul for $2,500. And good luck to you, my dear. Here it is. Blank plug. Blank plug. P-L-U-G. Okay, Barbara, if you give us the answer that Richard has written on the card, we give you $2,500.
Ear.
Yeah! Ear plug. You say ear plug, eh? Ear plug, eh? Okay. All right, a few people applaud, but apparently they've got something else in mind.
I'm sorry, I said spark plug.
Spark plug! Sorry about that. You got $350, Barbara. That ain't bad. Then you're going to meet another player later after we do a little business with America. Now let's say hello to Luann Odonino. Here we go. We're very happy to have you here. And we'd like to get acquainted with you a little bit. Tell us a little bit about yourself. I mean, you know all about us. Now we want to find out something about you, Luann.
I'm from Front Royal, Virginia. I am an editor for a small publishing company there. I have a six-month-old baby who is adorable and a mm-hmm. wonderful husband. And we live in the Shenandoah Valley, and it's beautiful but cold this time of year.
Not as cold as some places.
That's true.
Well, Luann, you live in a very pretty part of the country. You're a very pretty lady. We're glad to have you here, and we'll ask you to choose A or B.
A, please.
Okay. Luann says A. Sally said, traffic was so slow this morning, I got rear-ended by a blank. Traffic was so slow this morning, I got rear-ended by a blank.
Your rest did you an enormous amount of good.
Oh, yes.
I'm going to go there.
You've been there. Mm. Yes.
But I didn't look as good as you did when I came back.
Well, you didn't do all of the classes and all the exercise.
Oh, I did. I went in the pool and I did water play and
yes.
all that stuff.
And did you do all of the calisthenics?
Oh,
and all
yes.
of that?
I nearly had a heart
attack.
Going on a
3-mile walk every morning?
Well, no, I didn't do that.
Yeah, all right. We're talking about a wonderful place to go to condition your body, and some people certainly need it, called the Oaks. Hello, Luann. Sally said traffic was so slow this morning, I got rear-ended by a blank.
By a school bus?
Now you weren't paying attention. She said a school bus, Daryl. An unlikely possibility, because those
very unlikely possibility.
Those drivers are very good.
Who else is out there in the morning?
A jogger.
A jogger.
She was going so slow, you see, that even a jogger ran into her there. Oh, yes?
Well, you might find this an interesting answer.
Who might?
I don't mend then again. I said it was traffic was so slow, I got rear-ended by a stop sign.
Oh. Not that slow. Listen, you not only need a little time at a... exercise farm.
I'm going to a home.
No, you got to go to the Laughing Academy for a while there. What do you say?
Oh, this is worse. Turtle.
Hey, turtle, no, that's okay. Carl, that's all right. Anything slow is what we're after. Joggers, turtles, what else?
Person or pedestrian.
Hey, pedestrian, is that perfectly acceptable? Yes.
Mine's the world's oldest jogger.
And an old jogger, right?
A snail.
Snail would be good, too. All of those were good.
We
all right.
Care for stop
Stopped time. Car would also be good. There. We'll have one for
a
you
what?
In a moment. Right now, we've got a message for you. Don't forget to watch this pretty lady here on Angie. And this pretty,
this
tall
fella
with the teeth who does a wonderful characterization on Lou Grant. So look for him there. Don't forget, look for the mayor of Carter Country.
That's right.
He's powerful.
We got a new time.
We got a new time
starting in March. We're going to be on Thursday nights.
Okay. Anything else anyone have to say?
I did a pilot.
I don't got to hear about it.
I think we should say who plays my sister on it.
Right, now, next week when we all get together, these are the stars you will see.
David Doyle, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Ryder, Loretta Switz, Stoy Mitchell, and Fanny Fly.
Gene Ravenier, join us next time for Match Game 79. Thank you. Goodbye.